Welcome back. 9.3 was released yesterday. I think it was yesterday. Maybe 2 days ago. No, yesterday. Yesterday, yeah. And with that, some new weapons have been found in the files. And I don't go over new weapons very often until they're out because I like to actually use them myself. But in this case, I'm making an exception because it's happening. It's happening. They're finally vaulting the TAC shotgun. And this game is just a, you know, some background gameplay of me using the TAC shotgun and leaving the combats on the ground. But people have been asking for the combat, the TAC to get removed from the game for a while. Now, here's a quick little comparison if you look at the combat to TAC difference. 75 damage, fire rate's 1.5, magazine's 8, reload time is 6 seconds. Something to note as well is the TAC shotgun actually has a 2x damage headshot multiplier, where the combat only has a 1.75. So even though the combat, the purple combat, does more than the green TAC, 75 to the 77 of the combat headshot actually does less than the TAC headshot. So the TAC is a little bit stronger if you can get close range and hit the headshots, but let's be honest, the way people use shotguns in this game, that doesn't really work and never has. Most people rely wholly on that like mid-range shot from the pump or the combat, and you know, in this case now it's a spammable gun. But the new gun, the drum shotgun, looks like it's finally going to replace the TAC shotgun. It comes in the same rarity of gray, green, blue. And something to note is the range of it is 3072, which I'm not sure how they measure that exactly. It's not in tiles. It's not in pixels. They call them units, I'm pretty sure. 3072 is the range, which is the exact same range as the TAC shotgun. So those that wonder, I went and looked at some files here. It's the exact same range as the TAC shotgun. The difference, though, is the damage, right? So this image that I'm pulling up here is 5 damage. It says it's 5 damage. Now that's per pellet. Per pellet. So that's important to note because if you look at the damage of the TAC, it's actually, you know, it says it does 75 on a body. That means it's 7.5 per pellet. It does 10 pellets per shot. Same with the combat, I believe. Same with the heavy shotgun, I know for a fact. Same with the pump shotgun. Most of the shotguns run on a 10 pellet system. The blue TAC shotgun does 7.9 per pellet. So this is doing 5 per pellet, which is a little bit weaker, but its fire rate is over double the TAC shotgun and over double the combat shotgun's fire rate. So it has the exact same range as the TAC shotgun with double the fire rate, and it has a little bit less damage. The magazine size is 12 as well, which is even more than the combat. That's going to be nuts. This gun, I mean, the range is still really weak. And the thing is, you know, a lot of people don't, like I said, they don't play that close range spam shotgun style. It's usually the mid range. So maybe it doesn't really have a big impact on the game. But this shotgun is definitely superior to the TAC shotgun. It has the same range, over double the fire rate with slightly less damage. And if it holds the same headshot multiplier, which is 2, then it's going to be able to basically two-shot anybody. If you land 2 solid shots, boom, boom, faster than any other shotgun in the game, you are going to kill somebody. And since there's no one pumping in the game, that might actually make it, you know, the superior shotgun, we'll say. It could be a large improvement. And right here during this fight, I'm going to freeze frame in a second for you guys. I land a perfect body TAC shot. Perfect body TAC shot right there. So I freeze it. You can count the red dots, the red pixels. That is 10 shots, just to prove if you didn't believe me. 10 pellets per shot. Now going back to the combat shotguns, they also have 10 pellets. They do 73, 77, and 81 damage based on blue, purple, gold. 7.3 per pellet versus 7.7 versus 8.1. The range of the combat, though, is significantly larger than the TAC and the drum shotgun that will be released. I'm hoping that they actually vault the TAC, though. They could. This would be dumb, but they could in fact leave the TAC, and then we have 3 style of shotguns in the game at the same time. It's not unheard of, right? We've had the TAC pump double barrel, we've had the TAC pump heavy. It would be, you know, they could leave the TAC shotgun and say, hey, we're gonna have the TAC shotgun, drum shotgun, and combat shotgun. But because of how the drum shotgun works, I couldn't imagine them leaving the TAC. It's just, it basically is a exact replica of a TAC shotgun, except better. So I'm hoping that it gets replaced and that we have a much better close range shotgun. And if that's the case, then you may be able to change your playstyle to the point where if you W into somebody's box, especially in like a competitive mode, the playstyle is honestly get in the box and use that drum shotgun. The combat shot is great. It's more versatile. It's more, you know, it's more usable at the mid-range, long-range, and it's still good in the close range. The combat shotgun's fire rate is 1.85, which is a little bit faster than the tac shotgun's 1.5, but it's not 4. 4 is... that guy sniped at me. I shit you not. I looked away from the computer. That thing almost hit me square in the mouth. But the drum shotgun's fire rate is just so much faster that it may actually not be better than the combat, even inside of a box. But because of the versatility of the combat, people may prefer it. And the range, obviously. In competitive, if you're holding high ground and people fly up on you with like launch pads or rifts, whatever it may be, even using the Dysons or the Slipstreams, the combat shotgun can absolutely murder anybody in the air. I mean, it is the most terrifying thing to try to fly near anybody that knows to have their combat shotgun out. It's scarier than hell. It's so scary. But I look forward to having this shotgun in the game because everyone that I know has been tired, including myself, of the TAC shotgun. As I mentioned, no one's wanted it since like season three. I'm trying not to swear as much, man. I'm trying to be a better person. Since like season 3 or 4, the TAC shotgun's kind of been like phased out of the usable shotguns. So since then, people like vault the TAC. Every time they find a TAC, someone has a pump like this game's dumb. Vault the TAC. And they've tried a lot of the shotgun variations. As I mentioned, the heavy was really good for a little bit. The double barrel was absolutely nuts. The double barrel was crazy. One of the strongest guns in competitive for a very long time. And even after the nerf, it was still pretty decent because the pump could not one-shot for a while. I think that guy's controller died or something. He was just floating down real slow-like. But I wanted to stick along with the shotgun trend of yesterday's video because they buffed shotguns recently, as I mentioned. And this is going to go into factoring whether or not the shotguns are more usable, because in a fully auto close range shotgun, you're not going to use it in the same style that you would the combat or the pump. So the whole strategy that they just basically brought back into the game, which is very, very strong for good players, of shooting and then building and shooting and blocking shots and not getting punished by that timer, isn't going to be useful pretty much at all with the combat or with the drum shotgun. I'm sorry, because the drum shotgun is essentially in your face like the TAC, except even more spray heavy. And if you have the fastest firing shotgun in the game and you're point blank against somebody, very rarely are you going to try to build and block out. Typically, you're going to be the guy that tries to block them from building and try to get into their box even like harder. So that style that was just brought back into the game might be even more negated by the fact that the drum shotgun is going to be added in replacement, I'm hoping, in replacement of the TAC, right? So if you're trying to shoot build with your combat, and I'm just super hard W keying you, or if you guys don't know, some people ask what W keying is. It's when you basically just nonstop push somebody and you try as much as you can to just get into their face. If I do that and you are in a spot where you're just trying to build me out and I get into your box or I get next to you, I'm just going to hold down my right click. If you didn't know, the combat shotgun actually works that way as well. If you hold down right click or you hold down shoot, it will just keep shooting. You don't actually have to click it. I click it because I don't want to accidentally shoot and miss the player. But if you get next to somebody with a fully auto shotgun, which resembles the AA-12, honestly, from Call of Duty, with a fire rate that's faster than anything else in the game in terms of shotguns, then you could probably just hold down your click or hold down your shoot and lay into anybody. That guy had to redeploy. Freaking redeploy. I'm actually curious. I normally would get this done ahead of time for you guys in a video because I like having all this stuff laid out ahead of time. But I want to look up, while I'm doing this, double barrel shotgun in Fortnite. And this is only because I'm curious of the double barrel's fire rate. The double barrel fire rate was the highest in the game for a long time. The double barrel fire rate is 1.9. Wow. So the double barrel fire rate, I think they nerfed it a little bit maybe after a while, is still 2 times slower. 2 times slower than the drum shotgun. This thing's gonna be nuts. Oh my god. I'm just trying to imagine a shotgun firing that quickly. I really can't imagine. No shotgun's been like that, you know? I thought the combat shotgun was crazy with the fire rate, but this thing is gonna be literally AA-12 status from like MW2. You're gonna walk into somebody and just go, they can't do anything about it. It's gonna be like an SMG almost. I wonder how good it's going to be. On my sheets that I have, on all the information I've collected, I haven't seen anything that talks about damage of the shotgun against build. This was a problem for a while with the pumps, because double pump when it was in the game, it also did 100 damage against wood walls. So anytime someone build a wood wall, you just shotgun through the wall. They build a wall again, you shotgun through that wall. You can just instantly walk through all their walls while you simultaneously swap between shotguns and go through everything. But the combat shotgun structure damage is only 50 at gold. So you can only do 50 damage, it's really low. And the tac shotgun at structure damage at blue, the highest rating, is 55. So I would imagine it's probably going to be fairly low against structures. But even if it's fairly low, if you can just full auto it really quickly through a wall, and you know the guy is weak on the other side, it might just be a wall destroyer. I'm hoping that's not the case. I hope it's really weak against build. Because it was very frustrating, in my opinion, to have shotguns break through your build as quickly as the pump did for a long time. That was one of the fixes I proposed for the double pump originally was, hey man, make this thing like do less damage against my walls so at least I can outbuild it, you know? One thing I haven't mentioned, it's because we don't know, is the release date of the shotgun. I hope it's soon, because I definitely would like a replacement to the tac shotgun. This thing is just nowhere near as good as the combat. The combat's better in every way, in my opinion. But the drum shotgun can beat the combat shotgun in terms of body damage. If you went like straight body for body fire rate and DPS, the drum shotgun wins. So we're finally going to have a close range answer to the combat shotgun if we wanted that. Right now, the TAC doesn't even beat the combat close range. So I can't wait to use it.